Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. For this project I have used two identical Titanic model ships. I started this project by making the wreck first. In order to do this I had to build the first model completely, apart from the masts, the funnels and some minor details. As it is very well known, the Titanic had split in half when she sank, so I had to cut the model in half. I tried to cut the model with my cutter and then with my utility knife, but it was very hard to do it and I almost cut my fingers. So I then thought to use my soldering iron, and it was the perfect tool for this job. It really cut the vessel like butter. In the real wreck, some of the ship's decks and compartments are exposed, so I used a styrene sheet to create the various decks and compartments inside the ship. Now, if you look at the pictures of the real wreck on the web, you will notice that the vessel's bow is cracked and bended. So I have used my heat gun to bend the bow of the plastic model. Pictures of the real wreck indicate that a big part of the vessel's hull shell plating on the stern is missing and the various decks and compartments are exposed. So I removed with my cutter knife the hull shell plating of the model and then created the various compartments and decks inside the ship from styrene. Also in the real wreck, some of the engine's parts and funnels are visible. Therefore, if you are obsessed with details and making things as accurate as possible, like me, you can understand why I had to make these tiny engine parts and funnels, and I made them from a sheet of styrene. When the basic model of the shipwreck was finished, I started making the sea bottom from polymer clay. The reason I used the polymer clay is because part of the wreck is buried inside the sand. So I pressed my model on the polymer clay and made it look like it is buried inside the sand. After I finished all the details, I primed the model and it was time to create the rust. For the rust effect, I used this corrosion texture acrylic material, which I believe is very good and easy to use. Then I used some pencils to create the rusty color on the surface, which made the ship look like real corroded metal. Wherever I could not use the pencil, I painted with acrylic colors. So when the ship looked like exactly how I wanted, like an old rusty wreck, I started making the ship bottom. I used PVA glue and then used some microbaloon powder to create the sand. Around the wreck there are various debris, which are secured in place with PVA or super glue. Then I started making the second ship. I wanted this ship to be illuminated, so I drilled the portholes on both sides of the ship's hull and painted the ship with acrylic colors. When both the wreck and the second ship's hull were ready, it was time to do the resin pouring for the sea. For the base, I used this nice piece of wood I had on my stock. And for the illumination of the ship, I took the components out of this LED light that it is used to illuminate bottles. I made a hole on the ship's stern in order to place the on-off switch. Of course, I was very, very careful at this stage because even the slightest wrong move could make an irreversible damage on my diorama. I used the UV resin to create the waves. And then created the sea texture by using a water acrylic gel. Then I created the finest details of the water and the sea surf with a thin brass and white silicone. I have built this ship on previous videos, so I will not get into any details on how I have done it again in this video. But if you want to see more, you can check this video. I made the top deck in such a way that it can be removed in case I want to change the batteries at a later stage. So you can remove it, change the batteries inside and put it back in place. Of course, I had to find a way how to do this without disturbing the masts and the wires and the ropes and the Marconi cables. And you can see the trick I used in my Patreon page. After I have finished some details and I have put some smoke on the funnels and also put the Marconi cables in place, the diorama was finished. So this is it, the Titanic before and after diorama. I hope that you liked it, I hope that you enjoyed watching the process. I have started a new Patreon page where you can see additional content, more videos, behind the scenes, building tips, high quality photos, and I invite you to check it out. Thank you very much for watching this video, please hit the like button if you liked it. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe and push the notification button, and I will see you again next time. Goodbye.